We start our discussion on network motifs with a molecular switch. Switches are ubiquitous in networks, man-made or biological. Some switches work like rheostat, like the volume control in your music player, and some switches are binary, on or off. Here is a molecular switch. Suppose EK is a kinase that phosphorylates Y to YP. EP is a phosphatase that dephosphorylates YP. Both the reactions follow Michaelis-Menten kinetics. I have considered protein phosphorylation and dephosphorylation, but you can consider any other enzymatic modification of Y. For this switch, EK is the input and the steady state level of YP is the output. I will use an ODE based model to understand the possible input-output behavior of this switch. Here is the ODE for this model. We have used Michaelis-Menten formulation for both the reactions. Assume that the total amount of Y is constant. So replace Y by YT minus YP. At steady state, dYP dt is 0. Let's do some algebra and rearrange the terms. Replace YP by YT by lowercase y. This smaller y represents fraction of y phosphorylated. Replace Km1 by yt by J1 and Km2 by yt by J2. Then use V1 for K1 into EK and V2 for K2 into EP. Now it looks cleaner. Remember, EK is the input and the steady state of YP is the output. The small y is equal to YP divided by YT. So steady state of small y is equivalent to the steady state of YP. Similarly, EK is hidden in V1. So I can say V1 is input and the steady state of small y is the output of this switch. Rearranging the terms, we get this quadratic equation of y. Solving this will give the steady state solution. The steady state solution of y will be a function of V1, V2, J1 and J2. We call this Goldbeter-Kosland function. I am a bit lazy to solve the quadratic equation. Rather, I will represent V1 in terms of y and then analyze it graphically. Here is the plot when J1 and J2 are equal to 1. Small y is a fraction. It cannot be bigger than 1. So I will not consider the pink curve. The blue curve behaves like a rectangular hyperbola. Y increases smoothly with V1 and Y approaches 1 as V1 gets very large. So here the switch is working like a rheostat. When J1 and J2 both are smaller than 1, this blue curve is sigmoidal. J1 and J2 are the ratios of Michaelis-Menten constant to total Y. When total Y is much bigger than the Michaelis-Menten constant, the switch has a sigmoidal behavior. When J1 and J2 are much smaller than 1, this sigmoid becomes very sharp. So when the Michaelis-Menten constants are much smaller than the total protein, this switch is a binary switch. Up to a threshold value of the input, YP remains very low, that is the off state. Beyond the threshold, YP increases rapidly to the highest possible value and reaches the on state. This shaded region is the ultrasensitive region. Here Y changes very fast for small change in V1. Many enzymatic systems, particularly those in cell signaling, show such ultrasensitive on-off behavior. So let me jot down the key points. A simple system of reversible enzymatic modification following the Michaelis-Menten kinetics can behave like a switch. When the system is unsaturated, that is Km1 and Km2 are close to YT, the switch is rheostat. When the system is saturated, that is the total protein YT is much bigger than Km1 and Km2, the switch is an ultrasensitive on-off switch. The Michaelis-Menten constant is fixed for an enzyme. You cannot change it. But a cell can change the total amount of the substrate. Therefore, a rheostat can become an ultrasensitive switch if the expression of the protein is increased. And the opposite can also happen. That's all for this video. Thank you for learning with me.